Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. First of all, Assalamu alaikum. I welcome everyone on board for this third session of DBA, which is done by AMPKSA. AMPKSA has initiated this project, which is called AMPKSA Web Talk Series. And through this, we have done this series, which is the first one titled on the database administration. I'm really very much thankful to Jamal Bhai and Riyad team for doing this. So I'll just take a few minutes to talk about AMP and what are its activities, missions and vision. So AMP actually was formed back in 2008-2009 as an organization to fill the gap of giving a platform to Indian Muslim professionals where they can come, share their intellect and their goodwill and do some betterment activities for the community. So what we felt that there is a need of an organization which can bring up people on board and give them a platform where they can really contribute to the community. So this is what was the idea behind the AMP. Our mission is to empower the underprivileged for the greater benefit of society in general and nation as a whole. Our vision is advanced in education, which is reflected through the projects we do, socially progressive, culturally vibrant, definitely not, not reactive, not reactionary, politically influential. We are a political organization, but we want the community to recognize their importance in the political arena, and economically dynamic. So these are the missions and visions of AMP. These are some of the statistics which represents our achievement. We have, this is self-explanatory and some of it is covered already in the AMP intro. But this gives the idea of our reach of our program, the impact of our program, the influence of on the organization and individuals we had throughout our 10 years or 12 years of existence. Next slide, please. So I'll take 1 or 2 minutes to talk about this. These are some of the new initiatives launched by AMP India. AMP India has launched recently IndiaZakat.com, which is the first crowdfunding platform for Zakat. Then we have launched another path-breaking initiative, which is the IndiaMentors.com, and also Empower Jobs for to connect the. This is also a free portal for job seekers with comprehensive offering, including skill training, employability training programs. It is specifically created by industry professionals, voluntary for the sake of freshers and those affected by COVID-19 pandemic. These are some of the new initiatives which we have launched in the last 1 year itself. And these are groundbreaking ideas. And some of it are showing very good results, like IndiaZakat.com. We have able to help a lot of cases of financial situations. We have able to fulfill some of the requirements of medical aid and lot of requirements of self-help and business opportunities of small scale. We have been able to help with this. India Mentors is another nascent program which we are working on this, and this will help mentors and mentees, which is the mentorship is one of the core issues we have found within the community. This website will automate a lot of things, cut a lot of resources, and it will make a big impact on the community, inshallah, in future. Next slide. So this is the reach we have, around 140 plus chapters, around in 26 states, in 16 countries. We have, I'd like to take this opportunity to talk about a little bit of AMPKSA. So AMPKSA is mainly divided into three regions, central region, western region, and Eastern region. We have three chapters. We have three chapter heads, chapter secretary. Then we also have some core committee members who handle the chapters. We also have other GCC chapters. We have registered chapters in USA, Australia, and in UK. So next slide, please. In the end, I would like you all, whoever is, if he is from KSA, he can get in touch with me. My name is Habib Siddiqui. If you are in the group of AMPKSA, you will find my name in the admins list, or you can contact with any of the admins in the group. They are all responsible person, and you join us. So we are doing a lot of exciting stuff for self-development as well and for the community benefit as well. So it is not like you will come and you will give only to the community. Inshallah, you will join us and you will also benefit from a lot of programs we have. We have leadership development programs where we assign you projects. We walk you through these projects so that you also get an exposure to project management, project handling, resource management. So we invite you to join us. If you're not in KSA, you're outside KSA, you join your local AMT team. So that's it from introduction point of view. So to sum it up, AMT is a very nice platform, very well professionally managed in very much digital way of working we have. It which cuts the resources, minimizes the expenditure, and the impact we have is huge. So I request everyone to come and take benefit and give benefit to the community. Jazakallahu khair, Jamal bhai, again for arranging this, and I hand over to you.
Thank you, Abhi bhai. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for the wonderful brief about AMP. Now I would like to invite Mr. Shakir. He is having a master's degree, and from last more than 2 years, he is working in as a DBA. He has worked in many MNCs. Now he is working in KSA. So I'd like to invite him. And Mr. Shakir, are you there?
Hello, everybody. Assalamu alaikum, you all.
Walaikum assalam.
So let's begin with the today's session. Let me share my screen. So today we are going to take a sessions regarding backup and recovery. However, we have already completed the two session. The first session we have taken as a basic SQL, basic Unix, and background history about the Oracle. Then move ahead with the second session we have taken on Oracle architectures. And we have shown you all about the table space management and the user management. This all the session which we have taken is almost a usable and important sessions. There are many more sessions are there in the Oracle. Inshallah, if we'll get the time, we'll surely conduct that also, which will be a very add-on advantage for you all. So, however, we'll just begin with our today's sessions. Today's session is a backup and recovery. Today's session's backup and recovery. Before starting the today's sessions, let me recap you all regarding the older sessions. Deep onto the eight of the older session, but then to a little bit just like architecture, what we have gone through, and the table space management and the user management. The architecture, hope you all are clear who have attended my previous lectures about the background process, what are the five mandatory background process, SMON, PMON, DB writer, log writer, and checkpoints, how it works, what are the important component of SGA, how our select statement works, what are the three-tier architectures in the database levels, and the table space management, the important table space management like system, sysox, user, temp, undo, and the user management. The user management, I told you all about how the user means granting a privilege to the user. If anybody has joined to the organizations, how a particular DBA has assigned a privilege and create a new users for the organization who has just joined and company. This all are come under the user management, where you are creating a users and you are granting a privileges to the users, a specific object level privileges, and the sys level privileges. This all are in your hand because you are a DB. So this is all things we have covered on our earlier sessions. Now we'll just move ahead with the new sessions called backup and recovery. And inshallah, this after this backup and recovery, if you'll get a time, surely we'll just cover ASM, automatic storage management, data guard broker, which is also a very important. Hello.
Yes, go ahead, Shikesh.
Yeah. So let's start with the backup, RMN backup and recovery. So in the RMN backup and recovery solutions, as an Oracle provided to us, we have recovery manager. This recovery managers, earlier it means actually there are two type of a backup in Oracle, that it was used called as user managed and means RMN managed backup. Before the RMN introduced in Oracle, we were taking a user managed backup. I'll just tell you the brief about the backup and recovery about the Oracle. Like backup and recovery task for an Oracle database have changed over the year, especially with the advent and the future improvement of recovery managers, which we can call as RMAN. It's RMAN is a utility of an Oracle. Okay. That let's take a look back how the DBA would backup and database before the Oracle ATI without RMAN. Means now we are using a RMAN. RMAN is introduced in Oracle in 9i. Before 9i, how we were taking a backup, which we called as a user managed backup. Okay. So before the RMAN, we were taking a backup through alter command. Like if I wanted to take a backup of table space, I will execute a command alter table space name, begin backup. And then I will manually copy my backup in any of the backup locations. What will means happen when we execute, when I going to execute this command alter table space name, begin backup. It will freeze my header so that nothing can be updated on this on the my table space, which table space have been I have executed a command begin backup, and then I will do a match so that you can use a copy, you can copy the backup and all. I'll just show you the quick example. See, currently this is the RMAN. Okay, earlier, but there is no any RMAN. Earlier, if there is no any RMAN, how we are taking a backup? I'll just show you where is my data file location. So this is my data file location, U02 Aura data. So under this user, first I will just freeze my header of the table space or data files, whosoever I need to copy. I'm talking about the history first. Before the RMAN, what we are using, means we are using to take a backup, user manage. User manage means just a CP command. See, these are the file system I have, and in real time organization, you will have a one more file system called a backup or a storage or anything name, whatever you have created by your OS admin team. So that will be your backup locations. Now my file location is U02. See here, U02 Aura data. This is my. So these are all my data files. So what I will generally do, I'll just go inside the data file and I'll just cp my file. So why cp my file and under means any of the backup location. So before starting the cp, what I'm going to do, I'll just freeze my header by executing a command alter table space name, begin backup. Now I am not executing the command because it will take time and means we need to cover a lot of session, not executing command right now. So this is the means a general example, which I'm telling you all before means before 9i, when there was no RMAN in the Oracle, we were taking a backup using a user managed backup CP command, a normal CP command like this. So means Oracle could restore and recover the table space if needed. Of course, archive log also needed to be copied to a hard backup and entire database to be a pair of commands shown. See, I have told you that what are in the architecture. If you have if my previous sessions you all have been joined, I will also tell you structures. In the structure, we have a storage structure. In the storage structures, we have a data file, control files. We have archive log files, parameter files. So to recover our database, should be in a archive log mode. So to check if the particular database is in archive log mode or not, we can execute a command archive log list. So right now my database is in archive log mode, but I have not set the archive destination. It is a default archive destination called user USDB recovery desk. If you want to check the archive location, you can execute a reco. So my U03 FRA is my archive locations. So means in RMN, if you wanted to take a backup in on fly, means your database need not to be shut down and you need to take a backup, your database must be in archive log mode. If your database is in no archive mode, you cannot take a backup as a hot backup. What is a hot backup and cold backup? Hot backup where your database is up and running and you're taking a backup, and cold backup where your database is shut down and you are trying to take a backup is called a cold backup. In your database, if you are taking a hot backup and your database is in archive mode, that backup you can use for a restoration and recovery purpose when in any of the issues or in any of the occurrence when your database is crashed. Now let's go to the slide. So, Oracle Backup and Recovery Solution. We have recovery management, data protection concern. In the real time,
hello, Shakir. Your voice is breaking. Hello. Excuse me. Shakir. Shakir.
My database size was 50 GB. Now today, due to business, more 10 GB is added. But by today, one day as itself, I'm just giving an example of the size. Okay, so 1 GB, 10 GB has added. Now what is my database size? Now my database size is 50 plus today's 10 is total 60 GB. Now, if I am going to take a backup by today 10 PM again of level zero means full backup. It will going to take a more time because now my yesterday backup was 50 GB. Now today my backup size, my database size is 60 GB. So if I will take level zero backup, then it will take a more time from if compared to yesterday. So here the some key feature have been introduced by Oracle called incremental level one. What will going to happen if I will just take a backup incremental level one? Incremental level one will take a backup of only today's change data, means whatever the changes, whatever the today changes happen, that backup only take by incremental level one. So means if yesterday I have taken means incremental level zero backup, and today I'm going to take incremental level one backup. So whatever the changes, my like 10 GB changes has been made by today, that backup only going to be taken by incremental. So but obvious size and time both will be reduced. So in real time organization, the backup strategy is implemented in such a way like my weekend and rest of the day is my weekdays. So Saturday, Sunday is a weekend. There is no business. It was off business hours. We are going to take on that 2 days as level zero backup, database backup, and rest remaining weekdays we are going to take a incremental level one backup. So it will reduce our time as well as CPU consumption. Now let's go to the another thing. See, if you will see the recovery perspective, means the recovery scenario, I just put some key points in my slide, like media failure, block corruptions, user or logical errors, and disaster. So disaster is generally used for a data guard, where we data guard is an introduced by Oracle as a disaster management recovery purpose. Okay, inshallah I'll tell you about that also, but let me tell you about the this some key recovery scenario. Block corruptions means if some block is corrupted in the Oracle, you can recover it with your backup which you have by using a in the RMN. It was a good feature by introduced by Oracle. It just suggests you, means we have advisory features in the RMN which will suggest you means how you can restore and recover your particular backup and when it is available. See, if you wanted to see whether your backup is available in the database, you can execute a command and you can check the whether backup is available and it is not expired. So I have already tell you about the particular tape backup in the real time environment which is used, like means EMC. I'll just show you the configuration of that also, so it will be a more clear for you. Hope that the back data file backup which we have taken, it is completed. If you are not giving a specific anything, it will go for your array location flash. Here, if you will see configuration device type to disk. If you wanted to take a backup directly to your tape, okay. If you wanted to take your backup directly to your tape, then you need to configure your configure device type to tape in spite of disk. In spite of disk, you need to configure as a tape if you wanted to take your backup to the tape locations. And then you need to give a that tape location, server location means in server name and the configuration path of that specific server. So enable the flashback database while database is open. and it's increased the availability. Okay, the better management availability and minimum system impact. So means I have told you about the incremental backup and the cumulative backup. I have many points added. So I cannot cover up all the points in this short duration. But after this session, we'll inshallah share you all this PPT so it will help you all. So means I have told you about the means backup and recovery. The backup and recovery, the main thing is that how you take a backup and how you recover in very short duration. So means you will take a backup, you as a DB. And when you're going to restore. See here, if I have taken a backup, if I'll show you, I have taken a backup, data file one. And my backup is restored in this location. In this location, my backup is named is. See, if I want to see means what are the backup available right now in my Armin, I can execute a command list backup. So it will show my available backup pieces name and timing. See here, I have taken a full backup. This is my type. And this is my timing. In which date 25th September 2019, I have taken a full backup of my database. Okay, this all are backup pieces. These are the backup pieces name. This backup pieces name U01. See, if you will see here, it was written the pieces name also and the tag name. So while if something happened to my database, if I wanted to restore my backup on 25th of September, I can restore it by using this tag or by using this backup pieces. Just I need to give a command called restore and then backup locations. If you don't want it to give a backup location, you need to catalog that backup pieces. You need to give the
Akhil, we are unable to see your screen where you are typing because it is always in the bottom. So can you just drag it the console? Sorry. Yeah, this is better.
Okay, fine. So means if we while restoring, see if you want to see the backup pieces, I have shown you in the command. What is the command to execute to see what are the available backup I have in my Armin configuration. By using Armin, what are the backup I have taken? We need to execute a command list backup or list backup of database or backup summary. You can execute this whole command to check the backup pieces available in my database. Then it will show you the type of the backup. What are the type of the backup you have taken? Either it is full, whether it is incremental or it is archive log backup, it will tell you all. So here the same way, if I want to take my archive backup of a database, I need to execute command backup what will happen if I'll execute all, it will take a backup of my all archive log in the database, backup of a log sequence, specific log sequence. Then I need to define that log sequence name on my backup, like backup archive log until sequence, then sequence name. Like this, if I will give, then till that sequence, the backup will going to take. Now, right now, my log sequence is not more. It's only 7 log sequence because it is a test database. So I have taken a all backup my archive log backup through RMAN backup archive log all. So this is the archive log backup which is used for a recovery purpose. Means if you taken a backup of your database, okay, yesterday archive log backup. An archive log backup, and if something happened to your database in between, like I'm just giving you the real time experience and the example. Like I will already tell you that I am taking a daily backup on 10 p.m. and frequently by to every 2 hours I can take archive log backup. Archive log is not that much a big size, so we can take an alternate 2 hours or 3 hours archive log backup. So I'm taking every 2 hours archive log backup. What happened? My example I'm giving, you need to understand this whole thing. So if I am going to take a backup on the it's a transaction log. I have, if you have been in my older class, I have told you about the redo log files. Means each and every transactions and every changes redo log file is generated in every changes. That redo log file has been shifted to archive log. So means all changes, all transactions which is going to be happen, it's stored on the archive log. Okay. So means archive log is very important in the database. So means I have 8 a.m. in the morning, I can register. I can recover my database if I have an archive log backup. If I don't have an archive log backup, my database gets crushed. So I have my last backup of night 10 p.m. So on that scenario, I don't have any backup. I have backup of only 10 p.m. and my or you can only recover your database till yesterday 10 p.m. itself. And if you are having archive log backup, recently archive log backup, you can recover it till how many archive log you have. Okay, so this is the real time scenario. Now let's see. See, if you will see here it is written FFF and somewhere is written A. What is the A stand for? A stand for archive log and F stand for full backup. Okay. So here it is written the timing also when we have taken a backup and what are the tag. You can also restore through the tag also. Let's go to the slide again. Here we have some Oracle build tool. You can say as OEM. With the help of OEM also, you can take the backup and you can restore the as managers. In this Oracle manager also, if you want to take the backup with the help of Oracle Enterprise Manager, you can take a backup in one click. You don't need to execute the full lake and what are the priority you need to set, and if you will execute the backup tab, your backup will be happen using the Oracle Enterprise Managers. So you need to understand the backup policy as a DB. If you have a backup, means how you need to recover that backup, where is my backup pieces are there, and what are the possible things I can do to restore my backup. So if you, I have told you that the backup tape means in the real time environment, we have a backup tape, like see here, EMC. We have a EMC company, Dell EMC can say, who provide you the backup tape for your backup policy. And we have a HP also. This is a real time based real company who is providing a tape backup facility in your real organizations. Okay, EMC and HP. These are the two company. There are many other company, but the most popular and the company you are using like this is EMC and the HP. EMC is providing the backup solutions like a tape backup, and HP also. They have their own tools which will configure through RMAN, and with that tool, using a GUI, in the click you can take a backup. Shown you how the particular a rack which is having a more in some different tape and database and FRA and are on a different tape, so that it will be a less CPU and the networker consumption on the specific networker backup where we are taking the backup like this. See here, if you will see the command in the step number three, if I need to recover my database, okay, some files has got corrupted in my database. What I will do, start up my database in parameter file. Okay. Parameter, I have already told my last session about the database modes. We have a three mode like startup, no mount, mount, and startup. Startup, no mount, it reads a parameter files. What are the database configuration? In the startup mount, it reads the control file. What are the informations in your control file? And in startup, it reads the data files. So in the startup no mount, it reads the parameter files. You can give your parameter file name. Okay, startup no mount and parameter file location and the name. It will pick up your database with that parameter file configuration. Then you can restore the data files which is got corrupted, or restore. And then at last, after restoring, you need to recover the database. During the recovering time, what happened? It applies the archive log backup which you have taken till how long you have archive log backup recovered till then, and then you need to bring up your database. So I'll just show you all. There are some important the database backup details also in the database. If you wanted to see the database details on the these are the views called v$rmn view. You can see backup is completed successfully or not. You need to give the backup input type. It will show you the type, then backup status, whether it is completed successfully or it's showing some issues. Then the start time, you need to take the start time when your backup is started, when your backup is end. There are many fields based on your requirement you can use, but by using this details of your database successful or not, or at what time the backup has been taken. See you. And so here means some of my backup on 16 January it got failed of DB full because it was taking a long time. So I just executed Control C, it got failed. So here you can see whether my that 16 backup I can use for the restoration. No, because it got failed. This backup you cannot use. The backup you can use during the restoration. See, it's full. That data file one, if you have remember in this screen itself. So here it is showing data file full completed dot 20th Feb. You can see the timing also. You need to just execute the NLS date time format and you can see the specific timing as well. So these all are the some important key features of your backup and recovery. And the configuration of your RMN database. So I have also told you about if I want to take a backup of tables and schema. So for the tables and schema, we need to use EXPDB. RMN backup is only used for data files, control files, and means your table space if you want to take. These all things are used. If you want to take a table level backup, then you need to use EXPDB. That's it from my head today. And inshallah means more things we are going to cover on next lecture. Jamal, I hand it over to you.
Thank you, Mr. Shakil. So you are done with the session? Thank you, Shakil. Mr. Shakil, please accept our sincere appreciation for outstanding performance you made. Okay, we have covered three sessions on the database administration. Am I audible to all of you? Hello. Hello.
Yes, you are.
Okay. Let's see. We'll proceed for the question and answer if there is any. I'm going to see that. Thank you very much, Shakil, for your sincere presentation that you have done here. And I believe it was very interesting and very informative session that we have done. Fortunately, we are able to complete the different session. I'm going for the question and answers. I would like to see now if there's any question. Please be there. There is one question. What is the archive log? It's a transaction log or what? Okay.
Yeah, assalamu alaikum. Yeah, in between only, I just seen this question and I just explained regarding this in between only. Archive log is just a transaction only. Means if I have just give a brief explanation in my previous session in architecture, like means we have a redo log files, means any changes happen in the database, means like that it will going to store on the redo log files. And once the redo log file got full, it going to store on the archive log. So that is our archive log. Means, yeah, you can consider it's a transaction log also.
Okay, thank you. There is one more question. Please take one differential backup and need extension of that. I hope it's done, right?
Yeah, means I explained, but I have not shown you the practical example of differential backup. I have told about the incremental level one and the covered on that. As I have given the example also in the real-time scenario how the differential backup work and what is the means differential levels. That can be helpful, I guess, for you all.
There is one more question from Fayaz. Is Oracle syntax or function and SQL Server syntax are same or different? I believe this is purely
voice is not
PLSQL.
Yeah, Jamal bhai, your voice is not audible. Sorry, can you repeat again?
Sure. Question is Oracle syntax or function and the SQL Server syntax are same or different? I believe this is a PLSQL question, right?
No. It's totally different. It's an utility built by Oracle on NINI. So it's a different command. It's not the same with the SQL or pure SQL.
Okay. So both are different, you mean to say. Okay.
Yes. Both are different.
There is one I'm promoting. Another guy, Sikandar, is having some question. Okay. 1 minute. Sikandar, you can ask your question.
Hello, your voice is not audible, Sikandar.
Hello.
Jamal bhai, can you hear your
Sikandar voice? Hello, am I audible now?
Yeah, you're audible now. Please go ahead.
Now you're audible, please.
Hello.
Yes, please go ahead. Let's take the another question by someone called Casey. I'm allowing him to talk if he can.
Yeah. See, I just seen the question of Sikandar.
Okay.
He asked that can we take a RMN full DB backup in different mount point? Yes, Sikandar, we can take on a different mount point by using a channel. While taking a backup means you need to execute a run command in your RMN utility. Can I share my screen? Then it will be a little bit helpful for you.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, please.
So see here. See here. Means say in the run block, you can by using a curly creating a 6 channels that you need to put a different locations. Okay. Different locations on the channel. And by putting the locations and two different mount point location, and you can take the backup of your database, like backup database semicolon backup current control file. And this curly bracket close. So before curly bracket close and open, you need to configure a channel. Okay. Configure a channel on a different location of RMN, and then you can put the location of your different file system, and you can backup on a different location.
Okay, so in case if I need to take a 50 GB database backup, let's assume, and I have 5 different mount point with 10 GB space, or each five mount point have 15 GB space. So will Oracle automatically manages? Will it manage?
No. Oracle will not manage automatically.
Okay.
You are being a DB. You need to specify Oracle where your backup need to be taken. So means I have told you here, I'll just cancel this here.
I'm sorry, I understood. If I am assigning all these 5 mounts in 5 different channels, so can I assume that Oracle will write 10 GB in each mount?
No. On that time also, you have your one more parameter called max piece size.
Okay.
You need to give your max piece size to 2 GB, then 8 pieces will be configured, then Oracle will configure the backup pieces accordingly to the different file system.
Okay.
Yeah. means the exact parameter is configure channel device type disk format equal to your location, your different location. Then at the last you need to execute release channel.
Okay.
Means after ending your command like this.
Okay. Thanks for your answer. There is one more question. I'm just promoting him to talk. Say, can you ask the question? What is your question? I believe he is not able to.
You can also text like Sikandar if you are, means voice is not audible.
If there is any other question or query, you can drop us at jameel.nice@gmail.com. We'll be able to answer you for this. Okay. Thank you very much. I would like to do a special thanks to Mr. Shakil for completing three sessions for the DBA. This is basically a session from the AMP case, and we are able to successfully complete it. Now, this was really a very informative session, and we have thank you so much for sharing your time and the experience with us. We are all agreed that the lecture was very interesting and useful. We have a plan in the future that we would like to have few more sessions on the advanced DBA level. We'll do a discussion offline on this. Especially, I'd like to thanks to all the audience who joined us and MP family who conducted this, and all the KSA members who are running this webinar session. My sincere thanks to all of you for joining us, and I would like to request all of you, because MP believe in sharing and caring. Okay, I would like to request all of you that if you have a skill you want to present here in MP platform, we'd like to review. Inshallah, we'll give you the chance to. Chance to deliver the lectures. We have we believe in sharing and caring. So our major activities are there on the education and the employment. If you would like to join, please visit our website mpindia.org, where you can get all the information related to members wherever you are present, wherever your location is there. Thank you very much, everyone. Again, I would like to conclude the session on this. Now we can end the session. Thank you very much, everyone.